फ्रेंड्स, इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द इंटरफेरेंस, हाउ द इंटरफेरेंस पैटर्न ऑकर्स, व्हाट आर द वेरियस एग्जांपल्स ऑफ इंटरफेरेंस पैटर्न इन डे टू डे लाइफ that also discussed by us. Then what is the or what are the applications of interference in various fields? One of the important application of interference is nothing but the calibration. To calibrate different type of gauges, this interference pattern is used. Today we will see the interference which is observed due to transmitted light. In last lecture we have discussed the interference pattern due to reflected light, and for that what is the condition for bright and dark fringes, it also discussed in that lecture. Today here we will discuss the same, that is the interference due to transmitted light by the specific diagram. Again, what are the conditions for dark and bright fringes? See here, for getting the idea about a transmitted light, we will draw a diagram which is nothing but a thin transparent film which having a thickness T. As per in last lecture we have been drawn a transparent film. See here, this is the transparent film T having a thickness. These are the boundaries of transparent film, and this transparent film having a refractive index mu. Then see, this SA is a ray. We can say this is the incident ray on this transparent film, and this incident ray is partly reflected and partly refracted. See here, it is reflected along BC and refracted along BR. The ray BC, again after reflection at C, it finally emerges along this DQ. It takes the path DQ. Here at B and C, observe carefully this B and C. What happens in B and C? At B and C, a reflection takes place at the rarer medium, and when there is a reflection at a rare medium, therefore there is no phase change occurs. Means that rays travels in the same phase. Now we will draw a BM. This BM is normal to CD and DN is normal to BR. Then the optical path difference between this DQ and BR, this DQ and this BR, and that optical path difference is given by mu is the refractive index, addition of BC and CD, BC and CD. means we have to add this reflected ray BC plus CD, and we will subtract the ray BN, the ray B and N, this much part from BC plus CD, we will subtract BN, and therefore again we know the Snell's law, sin I upon sin R, refractive index mu equals to sin I upon sin R, and equals to what? This mu equals sin I BN upon MD, and BN upon MD is nothing but BN equals to what? Mu into MD, this mu into MD, and BN equals to mu MD. We will write here these things. Now observe in the figure, angle BPC, angle B, P and C, this much angle. This angle is R, that is angle of reflection. And the ray CP equal to what? CP equal to BC. This is CP. This CP equal to this BC equal to CD, this much. Means these are same rays, and therefore if we are taking addition of BC plus CD, this BC plus CD equal to PD, this much, this much ray, means BC, this reflection ray, again CD, this reflection ray, equals to PD, this much. And therefore here one thing is, that is optical path difference equal to mu into PD, mu into PD minus mu into MD, this much quantity. Optical path difference, that is mu into MD, this much. Means we are putting the values in this equation. We have the value of this BN array, that is mu MD, this mu MD. Then what is the BC plus CD? BC plus CD, BC plus CD is nothing but PD, and therefore this PD is there. Again taking a common refractive index factor mu, PD minus MD. See here, PD minus MD, PD minus MD is nothing but PM. PD minus MD means PD minus MD. See, PD minus MD, this much equals to this much PM. And now again we will see the triangle BPM. Where is triangle BPM? This triangle BPM. In this triangle, cos of R, this angle R, equals to PM upon BP, PM upon BP, and therefore it is nothing but PM equals to BP cos of R. This BP will go in multiplication, and therefore we will get PM equal to BP into cos R, but BP equals to 2T means this BP is nothing but twice time the thickness of the film, that is 2T. And if we are going to put the value of BP in this equation, then we will get PM equal to 2T cos of R. And here optical path difference mu into PM means 2, then mu as it is, then T cos of R. This is nothing but the optical path difference for interference pattern which we are getting due to transmitted light. Now we will see what about the bright fringes and dark fringes, what is the condition for it. See now friends, when the optical path difference equals to m lambda, then only the bright fringes occurs. Therefore it should 2 mu t cos of r equal to m lambda. This is the equation for bright fringes, where m is nothing but 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. the number of fringes. And now what about the dark fringes? For dark fringes, when the optical path difference equals to 2m plus 1 lambda by 2, when this condition is satisfying, then the dark fringes will obtain. And we will put here 2 mu t cos of r equal to 2m plus 1 in bracket by 2 into lambda. And therefore, here again, m equals to 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. In this way, friends, we have discussed the reflected as well as the transmitted light for the interference pattern, and by which we are able to say that the bright fringes or dark fringes are this and this condition, and by which we getting the idea. Thank you. Thank you very much.